Hi, in this video we're going to go over SCUBA regulators and everything you need to know before you buy. We want to give you all the information that we've learned over years and years of scuba diving so that you can purchase something that's going to make you happy and keep you diving for a long, long time without wasting any money. So stay tuned. So let's start with talking about what a scuba regulator actually is. The purpose of a regulator is in the name. It regulates the air in a scuba tank, which can be as high as 3,000 or even 3,600 PSI, down to about 140 PSI, and then further regulates it to ambient pressure so that you can breathe when you're scuba diving. Scuba regulators come in two stages, a first stage and a second stage. We're going to go over the first stage first. And the first stage connects directly to the tank. What it does is it takes the pressure in the tank. In the case of this particular tank, it's 3,000 PSI at its max fill, and it lowers it down to 140 PSI so it can become manageable when it goes to the second stage and you can breathe out of it. Without a first stage, you wouldn't be able to breathe out of a scuba tank. So after the first stage lowers the pressure of the tank to about 140 PSI, the second stage lowers the pressure even more depending on where you are when you're breathing. So this basically delivers air to you at ambient pressure, which is the pressure that you're feeling around you when you're underwater. The second stage is what makes it possible for you to breathe from the regulator. I want to talk a little bit more about the second stage because I want to explain to you exactly how it works so you can understand how it delivers air at ambient pressure. So if we look at our second stage here and I remove the cover, you're going to see this rubber piece. This is a diaphragm and this is flexible, as you can see. If I remove it, you're going to notice that there's a lever inside of the second stage. This lever is what controls the amount of air that you get when you're scuba diving. So the deeper you go, the more air pressure is going to be required for this diaphragm to be depressed. The more air pressure, the further down it goes, the more air it gives you. And that's how the second stage works. The diaphragm pushes the lever, and depending on how deep you are, the further down the lever goes and the more air you get. Before we move on, remember that when you buy your regulator, you're gonna have one first stage and two second stages. And the reason why you need two second stages is for redundancy. One is for you to breathe, and one is for you to breathe just in case this one stops working. Also, this is here should your buddy need to share air with you. So it's always important to remember that you need two second stages and one first stage. Let's move on to the materials that regulators are made of. Regulators are made of three major materials: stainless steel, brass, and titanium. The reason these materials are chosen is because they are less likely to corrode or rust, which makes them good for regulator manufacturing. Now, the major difference that you need to understand between these three materials is that of the three, titanium is the lightest. And some people like that because it is easier to travel with and it is less negatively buoyant when you dive. Honestly, I don't think it's worth it because titanium regulators are significantly more expensive than regulators that are not made of titanium, but it's an option should you like to get one like that. Before we move on to the rest of the video, if you're enjoying this video and you think this content is valuable to you, please click the like button for us. It helps us with the channel, it helps us grow the channel, and it helps more divers see our content. Thank you. Now, there are two types of regulators you can choose from. There are balanced regulators and unbalanced regulators. The difference is that unbalanced regulators react to the growing pressure around you. So the deeper you go when using an unbalanced regulator, the harder it can be to breathe. However, balanced regulators tend to maintain the same pressure regardless of depth. So if you're at 100 feet and you inhale, it's going to feel the same as if you were at 20 feet and you were inhaling. Another thing that you need to know about regulators is they come in either diaphragm or piston configurations within the first stage. And what that basically means is that it either uses a diaphragm setup or a piston setup to control pressure. Now, the main difference between these two is that diaphragm regulators are sealed from the environment. What that means is that no debris can get inside. So if you're somebody who is diving inside of a rock quarry or inside of water that is silted out, the diaphragm regulator is going to be sealed from the environment and it's not going to be affected by anything that you're diving in. Secondly, diaphragm regulators, because they're sealed, are less likely to freeze than piston regulators are. Another thing that you need to know about diaphragm and piston regulators is that diaphragm regulators are more expensive to service because they have more moving parts than the piston counterpart regulators. So that's something to keep in mind. We're going to talk more about servicing later, but just remember that a diaphragm regulator, because it's a little bit more complicated and has more moving parts, is going to cost more to service than a piston regulator. Now, if you're diving in cold waters, say 50 degrees Fahrenheit or less, the diaphragm regulator is the better choice. And the reason why is because it's sealed from the environment and it will not freeze. Piston regulators, because they are not sealed from the environment, are more likely to freeze in colder waters. So that's something to think about when you're choosing a regulator. It's important to mention that regulators connect to tanks in two different ways. There's the DIN connector and the Yoke connector, also known as the A-clamp. Now, which one you choose depends on which tanks you're using to dive. We have a video that we created that goes deep into the differences between DIN and Yoke, and which one is better depending on the type of diving you're doing. We're gonna put a link in the description to that video because that video is gonna have everything that you need to know to decide which connection is right for you. Let's go ahead and review some of the features of a regulator. The first one I wanna talk about is ease of breathing. This is important because you want to know what it's going to feel like when you breathe that regulator. Unfortunately, there's no way for you to really know until you buy it. So one of the things that we recommend is for you to go online, do research on the different regulators that you're looking to buy, and see what the people who are diving them have to say about them. The next thing I want to discuss is the mouthpiece that you buy for your regulator. Now, mouthpieces are interchangeable. So if you look at this mouthpiece here on this second stage, it's connected with a tie wrap. This can be changed, and there are different types of mouthpieces. So in that regard, you can look for the mouthpiece that you think is best for you, and you can try out different ones regardless of the regulator you buy. Next, I want to talk about the number of ports. On this regulator, you will notice that there are 1, 2, 3, 4 low pressure ports and 1, 2 high pressure ports. The number of ports on a regulator is important because it's going to determine where you can put your hoses and how many hoses you can attach to your regulator. Lastly, I want to discuss swivel turrets. If you look at this regulator, you will notice that the top of the regulator spins. This is a swivel turret, which allows you to move it around to set it up on your tank the way that you feel comfortable. Regardless of which regulator you buy, you're going to have to maintain that regulator regularly. Every single time you go diving, you're gonna have to rinse and dry your regulator. Also, it's important for you to know that regardless of which regulator, your manufacturer is gonna recommend that you maintain it within a certain interval of time. And you need to check with the manufacturer's specifications on that so that you maintain your regulator based on the manufacturer's suggestions. On top of that, it's important for you to understand that some regulators are more expensive to maintain than others because their parts kits are more expensive, they have more parts, and that's something you need to think about. Lastly, if you're buying a regulator, especially if you're considering buying a used regulator, it's important for you to know that older regulators may not have parts availability. So that is something to think about if you're considering buying a used regulator. This brings me to something very important, whether you should buy used or new regulators. The reality of the situation is that when you're buying a used regulator, you're buying something that you do not know how it was used before, how many times it was used, or how well it was taken care of. So if you buy a used regulator, the one thing that you need to know on top of everything else is that before you take it diving, you need to get it serviced, because you want to make sure that that regulator is in tip-top condition before you go underwater with it. Honestly, my suggestion is not to buy used regulators. Unless you're getting a screaming hot deal on the regulator, it's just not worth the trouble. So how do you decide which regulator is right for you? The first thing you need to think about is the type of diving you're doing. Consider the environments that you're diving in. Do you dive in cold water versus warm tropical water? Are you diving in environments that are silted? For example, like a rock quarry, or maybe even the area that you're diving in has water quality that isn't that great, and there's a lot of material in the water. That's something to think about when you're choosing a regulator. What is your budget? How much money are you going to spend? You need to keep that in mind as well, because you want to buy the best possible regulator that you can get for your money. Do you travel? If you travel, then is titanium an option for you? It's something to think about if you're worried about the weight of the regulator when you're traveling. Also, think about how many ports the regulator has. Do you dive a dry suit? If you do, you're gonna need an extra low pressure port. Are you diving a dive computer with air integration? If so, you're gonna need a high pressure port for the air integration on the dive computer. Also, you might wanna have another high pressure port for a brass SPG so you can have a backup. Do you have any questions about regulators? Is there anything we missed that you think we should have added in the video? If so, please comment below. If you're a diver and you like this video, then you're gonna wanna download our free guide, The 4 Keys to Mastering Your Diving. It's over here on your right. In it, we go over 4 little known tricks that you can do right away to increase your comfort underwater, become a more efficient diver, and have longer, more enjoyable dives.